Hi, welcome. We're here at one of the places I've got my hydraulic ram pumps running, and I'm going to take you through what I'm using it for and where it's set up. So let's get to that.
Here, this is one of the barrels I've got filling with one of my micro ram pumps. This is the barrel that's been filled. The line goes up over this track into this tree. It then runs down this tree here, and our pump is currently tapping away down there. The intake for this pump is just here where the red funnel is, and all I've done is built a small dam there, and pump takes out. I do have problems occasionally with this silting up. All you've got to do is come and just wipe off the filter every couple of days. It's not a problem. It is currently supplying water into this barrel, which is supplying drinkers to this pen here full of pheasants. So they need checking on daily anyway. What this does is it saves the effort of carrying water here in 25-gallon drums. 5-gallon drums. We'll head down and have a little look at this pump, eh? So currently this pump's been up and running for 3 weeks, 3.5 weeks, something now, without break. So it's kind of withstanding the test of time. This one has the plastic flapper valve inside, not the ball bearing one that I've built the other day, but the construction is exactly the same. In all the time it's been running, you can see here there's not actually a huge amount of water coming, and the line on this bottle is actually from the first time I had it running, where the water level's at, so I can check and see how much water's air's dissolving into the water. Rather than using that flexible black pipe in here, I've just used some blue 13mm, and if you can see there's Jubilee clips on the top. The bottom ones are just friction fit, and that's good. The T-junction on this one is made from a pen that I've just literally cut and melted together. Apart from that, it's constructed exactly the same as my other ram pump. As you see with this one, the flapper valves do seem to be able to get a little slower of a rate with, but they're set up in exactly the same way, and this is currently the only amount of flow you need for this. This pump's been managing over top pump rates. For this setup, I've had 250 litres out of it, and I've actually slowed it down slightly, because the amount of water I had was totally unnecessary for my applications. So that's the pump. Go back up to the high point in the system. It's right up there in the tree. And then the barrel. You can just see the barrel over there up the bank.
I hope that's been useful for you to see where I'm using these micro ram pumps. There is one last weird thing with the ball cock. The only way that I've managed to get the bottle cock to successfully work filling a barrel is pointing the system high up. I've got a T, and it's going to be difficult seeing out. That runs to a standpipe that's higher than everything else. When the bottle cock shuts off, the pump just reverts to pumping water out of this little pipe up here. Another way of doing it is just to have a bucket. The bottle cock's fed off a bucket, and the ram pump fills the bucket. Whichever way you do it, it doesn't really make a huge amount of difference. So again, thanks for watching. If you've not seen me build the ram pump and you're interested, check out that video. It came out a couple of days ago. I think its title is How to Build a Mini Micro Hydraulic Ram Pump. And be sure to subscribe. Thanks a lot.